All right, and then a couple of brief things we need to approve the agenda. Can I get a motion to approve the agenda as written?
Motion to approve.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, and approve the previous minutes?
I second.
All in favor of that? All right, so first I want to do some introductions. I know there's some new people in the neighborhood and possibly online. And so first of all, I want to introduce the board. So Steve Krim is on our right, our left. And then we have Mike Delaney, Ray. It's been a long day.
I never got into a problem.
Corey Elhouse. Corey collects the money, so he's the most important person. And then myself, Patrick Hoffman. And then I wanted to also introduce all of the new owners that we have. So Doc and Cindy Gibson, they're actually online. So you guys can see them, but you can see his picture up here. Everybody knows they bought the two empty lots down on the far west end, basically right next to the back house and across the runway from where I
live. I live there too.
What's that? Yes, I live too. So the next ones we have are Casey and Brittany Bickle, and there's Casey.
Yep.
They bought the Harris place, which was basically right over here in the middle of the runway. Bob and Michelle Clark, did not see them come in. They're online.
Okay.
So yes, they're right next to the Tomlinsons, who are right here. So Tom and Robin Tomlinson, who bought them the pad house. And then we have Keith and America. I'm not sure I'm pronouncing that name right. Bartlett. So they bought the empty lot that is next to the blacks. And I don't see them online or here. So. But they've got stakes on, so apparently they're planning on building. So next, before we get into.
We got one more. We got Jerry and Linda here.
We've owned for 4 years, but just finally getting around the building. So, looking forward to it. Hopefully, this time next year, we'll be here full time.
So, before we get into any discussion with the other items, I wanted to lay out just a couple of ground rules. As we pause and say welcome to the nation. Just a couple things. We're going to have some discussion about a couple items. And I want to make sure everybody understands that we don't want any political comments. We don't want any personal attacks. And if there are any disagreements with those rules, the grievance committee is meeting right outside that door. Feel free to go meet with them. All right, next there is, where's Eddie at? There's Eddie. Eddie has a brief statement to make about putting together paperwork for a pilot briefing, actually for everybody to brief about how pilots work.
Jack Tessa and Mike Moore were assigned to task a while back to kind of help a little bit of a safety plan. And the big concern was for the non-pilots that are residents in the area and visitors, guests, contractors, what have you. So we're looking at a twofold process, one of which is a little guide for the pilots, which we're putting together. And we certainly look for input from the pilots. I'll send out requests from the for things that you might want in the pilot's guide. An example would be, we know that the traffic pattern officially is 1,500 feet, yet from an AFD perspective, when everybody likes coming a little bit lower. So things that we might want to put in there, and we're not going to discuss the pilot side of it right now. What I did do is develop a slick. And a slick is a one-pager, easy to read, Information is important for the non-house and residents. You guys can look at that, kind of pass it around a little bit. I will send one out for comment, but it's certainly not my committee, as it were. So what's on right now is pretty much kind of a final review, unless you see something that's grossly missing on this non-house guide. And we want to do a couple different things. We want people to realize that it's an airport community. The airplanes have right away, and you got to consider that. We also have people that don't understand what a rock does. So we want them to understand the kids, children, pets, whatever, kind of be aware of that. And then a little bit of statement regarding contractors. I had the unfortunate thing of, one, having a fairly wonderful life with no flat tires since I lived here. I've had three. So that's caused by, obviously, the roofing contractors.
Can you talk over by Patrick's computer a little bit, because the people online say...
My apologies. Movement with purpose in my life. bottom line is, what we're trying to do is just get stuff out for people to understand the rolling environment and, of course, the taxi environments. And if you look at that little page, you'll see basically kind of a little bit of where airplanes go and where they don't go, and some very strong language regarding the runway. Clear, concise, and again, this is all for the non-pilot residents and for their guests. And if they want to hand these out to their contractors, whether they're gardeners or whether they're roofing contractors or whatever, probably a darn good idea. And again, last thing, and this is from Jack and Mike's and my perspective, is we'd like to get some input regarding things you'd like to see in the pilot's version of this, which won't have a bunch of pictures in it. It'll be something simple. And as to whether we have a separate page on the back side of that one is, you know, focal point debatable. Any questions about any of this so far? On that note, everybody good?
Thank you.
Well, I don't know if everybody online was able to hear that. Eddie put with Mike and Jack put together a one sheet briefing for basically non-pilots, and we'll be sending that out to everybody in the near future. All right, so I have some good news to report tonight, or good potential news. So the lawsuit that has been underway for 2 years or so is in the settlement stages. So I'd like to read portions of that, relevant portions of that to you. So this agreement sets forth the understanding between all parties of the lawsuit. They agreed to dismiss all claims and defenses brought in the lawsuit, and we agreed to the following. So on or before February 3rd, we have an open session meeting, which this is, and we will approve the motion to present the consent order to the court. So once I read through the consent order, the board will make a motion to approve that, and that will get sent to the court then, and then we'll proceed with the dismissal of the case with prejudice. And there are a couple of stipulation requirements to get this completed. And so what it's saying is that we authorize the board of directors to hereby buy future boards of directors that Whiteplains will not attempt to change the private nature of the airport or otherwise make the airport a public airport as defined by the FAA, except as set forth in paragraph 2. Paragraph 2 says, if the Lexington County zoning laws and regulations that currently protect Whiteplains Airport and airspace from encroachment change to such a degree that the association must make the airport public in order for its members to use the airport, basically like the current user. We have zoning regulations that are taking care of keeping tall towers from being built at the end of the runways right now. So that's one option. Or the second option is, if at least 80% of the then current members of White Plains in an election pursuant to the covenants decide to change from private to public. Or the third option is if James Weed and Dennis Perry are no longer property owners at White Plains. So any one or more of those things would be required to change it at some point in the future from private to public if we ever want to. As we've said from the very beginning, we only wanted to take the airport public to get the FAA's protection for zoning regulations and to prevent towers from being built at the end, apartment buildings, etc. So it doesn't really change anything, but we're agreeing to that so that we can settle the lawsuit. And so that's what the consent order is. So if everybody agrees with that, I would like to request a motion to approve it.
I'll make a motion to accept.
Second.
All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay. So that is approved. So now we'll go before the judge and sign the order to dismiss the lawsuit with prejudice, which means they can no longer, nobody can refile the same lawsuit for the same reason. All right, moving on to the budget, and I will turn this for you.
There, no money's exchanged hands. What was stated here is the final agreement. That's it. 2 years to get to that.
So, Steve, a good point for anybody online to put here. There is no money that's exchanging hands. It's just the three stipulations that I read that those are the requirements of the lawsuit.
Happen?
Yes.
Where do we, in the situation of encroachment, where do we stand with the new development that is, they're building like crazy now, picked up again, and any other very close-in developments that they're going to place off of the northwest corner in terms of future problems dealing with noise and dealing with overflight?
Well, the zoning regulations really don't deal with noise or overflow. They basically deal with large capacity buildings, like apartment buildings, tall objects, towers, buildings that go into the airspace. So they really don't discuss that. And they are far enough outside of the approach zone that the height is an issue. So,
well, it's not an issue for height, obviously, and that type of.
So you guys know those signs that are over there?
Sure.
The ones that say, low airplanes? We put those there specifically because of that development going in. We wanted to advertise there is an airport here. Not that we want to have people coming in here, but we want them to know that there are airplanes flying here. That's why we put them there. Hopefully that will mitigate, reduce, help with that. So that they can't say I didn't.
Well, I'd be very surprised if you had those people that fully understand that there is an airport here, and there is. This is a concern.
For anything, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, there's no disclosure laws in South Carolina either, so they didn't even have to know there was a landfill or anything here. So that's the other thing. There's no disclosure.
And for those online, just to repeat what Corey asked, he was asking about the development, if this protects us in any way, then the zoning laws from future lawsuits for noise or public license standards, like that statement, it's basically for buildings and approaching the airspace. All right, can we move on to the budget?
Sure.
It's all you.
Okay, on the budget this year, well, actually last year budget, we were able to actually keep saving. We're putting money in savings. Added extra $15,000 to the fund A and the fund B. The CDs, I guess, are kind of a non-issue now. They're just like savings accounts. We're not making anything on the CDs yet. We've left them there because they turn over every 3 months. And hopefully if things start to pick up, we'll get a little bit better in the CD area. And that's why you'll notice, I'm sorry?
Can you hear me, Pedro?
Okay. In the 22 budgeted interest income, I put all question marks because it's just, it's all over the place. And so I can't even put a number on it. So, and it's been so little. I mean, it's between a savings account and a CD, it's like a percentage of a percent. So it just doesn't matter. But I'm leaving it there, and hopefully when things pick up, we'll start moving it around. And because this is an HOA fund, that's pretty much all I can do. I can't move it into other things. It's against the law. So anyway, it's in the CDs, we kept it there. So the interest income, kind of, yeah, wait to see. HOA dues, we didn't increase the dues this year, so ditto. It's going to be the same as it was this year for next year. The actual budgeted items, we've added a little bit to some of the categories, like the HOA drainage miscellaneous, we added to that, and the aviation drainage miscellaneous repair, we added to that, and that's to accommodate some of the tree cutting that we want to do at the east end. So once that gets rolling, which I think we're going to talk about here, okay, and once we get that rolling, we'll have money set up. Landscaping, we added a little bit more to that because our landscapers charging a little bit more than last year, or I'm sorry, he was here last year than the 2 years. He hasn't raised it this year, but I had to make that more in line with how much he was charging. And what else was that? Electricity is pretty much the same, that hasn't changed. We've added a little bit more to legal counsel. Only because of the bylaws that we have ongoing, and there'll probably be money for that. So, are there any questions on any of this at all? On the budget, on next year's budget, on the actual amounts?
Has everybody paid their fees?
We're getting there. We're almost there, yeah. I always have some that are lagging behind, but yeah, we managed to make it. So, as far as last year, no, everybody's paid up for last year.
Approximately how many people haven't paid?
I'm sorry?
Approximately how many people haven't paid?
There's probably about six. So, yeah. And, yeah, so, oh, and then one other thing, too, on the very bottom of this, we put a couple categories out there, and it's a drain repair for the sub and the entire, like, up and down the runway. You know, there's a couple areas where the drains have actually sunk down, and we want to bring those up to grade level. And so that's in there. And then the west end, there's proposed tree cutting, and we kind of put an amount out there. And these are all, we don't even have estimates on any of those, so it's kind of like we're putting out, like, you're just saying, here's what it might be, but I have a feeling that if it comes to something like this, we'll come to everyone for a special approval. Any other questions?
Corey, and then the landscaping, is there any funds for replacing some of the shrubbery that has died and the sod, especially that center island in phase two? I think it's the conduit. Infestation killed a lot of that grass. It looked really nice up until a few months before.
Yeah, no, there's nothing to aside for that. And he doesn't, I mean, that's his flat fee is for what we define it at this point. But that, I know that's not it.
And then, so there's a couple other things I wanted to highlight. You were talking about legal expenses. The lawsuit that I was discussing, there's a deductible with our insurance. That's $1,000. So that will be coming out of that. One other thing would be the repairs, the service entrance road. Everybody's been in and out of that recently. And I was going to fall apart towards the left side. Hopefully get something done on that. Fence replacement, I sent out a survey. Spring, I think it was. Everybody pretty much said keep the same, just repair it. So we'll replace pieces as needed. paint reflectors. We're hoping to do that on the runway at least, and maybe the taxiway, I mean, for a hope to come back. And then the tree trimming, you already mentioned, for the west end. And we do have tree trimming on the east end already built in there. And that's, it started, basically they had the, some of the underbrush cut out so they can actually get towards the trees closer to the front to dry out. So hopefully that'll happen.
We're getting close. It's a real touchy subject because three of the trees are on someone else's property. And it's very touchy. I'm trying to get the right people that they approve, and we think we've got it. And Mike and I have been working on that, and hopefully within the next few weeks, maybe you'll see some activity. So that's what we want.
And then the last major thing, like you mentioned, the drainage projects. We talked about this a while back, and hadn't really got the estimates back that we're looking for, so we're hoping to get that this year. On the southeast part of the runway, basically from Billy Bridger, kind of boxes, that they need boxes, down to kind of a quarry and that sort of. So, and then also in front of the maintenance shed, we'll do some work on that so people aren't driving a trailer, it's a big hole there, and raising the drain that's in front of gardeners between the runway and the taxiway. So that's kind of the scope of what the drainage is. All right.
Thank you.
Sorry?
Regarding the HOA maintenance that was mailed in, are you sitting on the check? Because we still show marks on the thing mailed in some time ago.
No, everything has been mailed in. Or everything has been sent to the bank. When I give them a big handful of this, I don't know how long it takes, but everything's a positive.
When did you send yours?
When you go ahead
and clear them, you may wait. Yep. Oh, no, I put yours in a while back, so you should be seeing that.
That was terrible.
Okay.
Just something that I had to mail right now is
horrible. Mail running.
Yep.
Slow.
And why?
All right, we have edit
very quickly. On that note, our mail carrier, where mail carrier here is retiring and moving on, and down to two people versus three, so expect the mail to slow down for a bit.
We got mail carrier that's retiring, so mail coming here will be even slower. Okay, any other comments on the budget?
Yeah, do we have anybody that could make a motion to approve the budget?
Make a motion to approve.
Second. All right, all in favor of approving the budget as?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any online opposed? All right, sounds like it's unanimous. Moving on to the election results. Mr. Hill.
I have it. Balance that, man. Okay, I received 55 valid ballots, and of the candidates, our new elected directors are Casey Bickle, Corey Althouse, and Mike Bullock. We've got tallies up here if anybody would like to look at it, and the board has the all the ballots. Congratulations.
All right, so that is, did everybody hear that online? Casey Bickle is a, so Casey Bickle, Corey Althouse, and Mike Bullock were elected to the board. And that is all we have for our meeting. Unless anybody has any
questions. Speech from Casey.
He's gone a very long or two away.
I think I have him stand up now. I think I
was happy to be there.
Yeah. yet, but I'll figure it out along the way. So we'll see. I appreciate it.
So that means that we'll have a function to adjourn. Thank you all for joining us online, and we're going to.